Hello, fellow 3D printers. I'm J-Wall of Print That Thing, here to feed y'all some 3D nuggets. 3D printed ovaries. Forbes reported that Northwestern University presented the Endocrine Society with their crazy results of 3D printed prosthetic ovaries in mice. These prosthetic ovaries were actually able to conceive and bear living young. The 3D printed implants were created with human applications in mind, and the team behind it hopes that one day they'll restore fertility and hormone function to women who suffer from side effects of cancer treatments and genetically reduced ovarian function. Sculptable 3D printing filament. It's like Play-Doh and 3D printing had a baby with 3D printed ovaries. Adam Bean Industries announced back in December that they'll be releasing a line of sculptable filament later this year. The idea is based behind the company's CX5 and CX5S line of sculpting material that allows for sculpting after cooling. The company stresses that these materials are not final materials and all sculptures should be molded and then cast in the material of your choice. The sculptable filament will be available for desktop FFF 3D printers and will be released later this year. Massachusetts-based company Voxelate has figured out how to 3D print with embedding electronics and conductive ink. The Voxel 8 printer is designed to pause automatically to allow for addition of electronic components. Then the printer prints the conductive ink traces that connect those components. They've worked with Autodesk to help with the layout of design and electronics. These printers are available on Voxel 8's website for the developer's kit and a standard printer pre-order, which will ship later this year. French company Z3D Lab has created titanium ceramic printing powder. The powder is called ZTI powder and is to be used with selective laser melting printing. Fused with titanium and zirconia, the material is believed to eliminate allergies that are usually triggered by titanium implants, opening the door for dental implants, prosthetics, plates, staples, screws, and much more within the medical field. 3D printing robots. MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Lab have done it again. They're developing a 3D printing technique that prints solids and liquids at the same time. Motivated to create printable hydraulics and step closer to rapid fabrication of functional machines, the team has developed an 8-part inkjet head that deposits multiple materials for complex pre-filled fluidic channels. To demonstrate this, they printed a 6-inch adorable little hexapod robot that took 22 hours to print. It moves using a 3D printed hydraulic system and a DC motor. The team has also printed a silicone rubber hand for MIT's Baxter robot that uses liquid to move his little fingers. It's adorable. 3D printing shoes. The New Balance Zante Generate is the first 3D printed running shoe to be made commercially available. But there's a catch. Only 44 pairs will be printed, making these sneakers super limited edition and $400. As a collaboration with 3D Systems, the shoes will be included in 3D printing shoe technology history with Nike, Adidas, and Under Armour. While 3D printing shoes is still too slow and too expensive for mass production, it's believed that 3D printing shoes will be something of the future. 3D printed cast. Mexican startup MediPrint has created the NovaCast. The NovaCast hopes to replace how we treat broken bones. These colorful casts are waterproof, X-ray compatible, don't absorb sweat, and allow for airflow and skin access for those pesky itches. Thanks for watching. Feel free to subscribe if you like 3D printing, and we'll see you next time. Happy printing.
This is the moment for those who...